So here we have the Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross on an 18 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you inside the boot of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls from there. As you can see, we have reversing sensors, plenty of boot space as well, along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat should you wish to increase this space even further. And then underneath this carpet section, even more space again. Okay, now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the left-hand side, we have the rev counter, and on the right-hand side, the speedometer. In the middle, you can see the total miles for this car, which are 25,365. In that section directly above that, we have a fuel gauge and coolant temperature gauge. You can also see the gear this car is in, so we're in park at the moment, highlighted by that big P in the middle there. And then we have the trip computer above that section. If we back out to the steering wheel, on the left-hand side, we have stereo and phone controls. We also have buttons up here for changing tracks and the volume for your stereo. On the right-hand side, we have cruise control and speed limiter. Just behind the steering wheel, the minus and plus paddles are so that you can change gear manually on this automatic gearbox, should you wish to. Over in the center, we have the main screen for the car. So at the moment, we are on the DAB menu. We can go back to the main menu. All the movement that I'm making on the screen at the moment is all being done using this pad just here. This works a lot like a trackpad would do on a laptop. So you can hear it beeping. That's me scanning through left and right. You can also push this button down as well. So for example, if you wanted to go into your DAB radio, push the button down, you'd be in the DAB radio menu. You can see up here, we've got a lot of menus. So DAB, FM radio, your phone, Bluetooth audio, and you'll see all of those as I scroll through. So lots and lots of different options for music up there in total. If I put the car into reverse, you'll also see the full color reversing camera with guidelines that show you what direction the car is headed in relation to the image being shown on the screen. Working our way down, we have the dual zone climate control. So you can adjust the passenger temperature, the driver temperature, you can increase and decrease the fan speed. That button there will turn your air conditioning on and off again. Or hit auto, the car will now maintain the temperature you've asked for by taking full control of the fan speed for you. You can override that whenever you wish to by making any manual adjustment. You see auto has now gone off. Underneath that section, we have a 12 volt charging socket and two USB inputs. This button will put the car in eco mode. We have the gear lever for the fully automatic gearbox. We have a heated driver's seat and a heated passenger seat, both with two different heat settings on each. And this button will lock the car into four-wheel drive. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.